Hey horse people, I want to cover a couple of things here. Wind's coming in the microphone, so you'll probably hear it. Of course, it just blew as I started. I wanted to go over a couple of different combs that I use for trying to make sure Mr. T don't move. There's a new brush out that somebody said it's nothing but a bunch of these in a line. This little hacksaw here has little blades on it. It's not going to cut the horse unless you run it this way. If you run it this way, it's just going to scrape and tear the hair. It will get some hair off, and it's not too bad, and I'll use it. This little comb we used to have in the military, we use it on our dogs. I don't know what they're called or even who makes them. Let's see if there's a name on it. There you go. Can you see that name? Maybe y'all can see that name on who makes it, because I can't read it in the sun. But let's see if I can move it to where I can read it. KMC something. Anyway, these little guys work great. This is what I use on Smokey, my cat. It really strips the internal hair out. They work great on dogs for stripping out that inner coat. And I'll show you on Mr. T how it works on pulling that out of him. And then this is just a regular old curry comb, which I always like. And then I have a rasp over there that I'm going to show you how to, I think I've done this before, how to remove mud if you're doing your own feet. It's been muddy and wet. I just able to hose Mr. T off and do his feet. So I wanted to go over a couple of these little things here. So let's go try a few of these. Might get Mr. T not to move. I'm going to come in this way so he doesn't move. You're right. I know. I crossed you. Put that foot up. One more. I know. All right. I think he's still in here. So you can tell there's some little dirt here where he's kind of, he's been out in the mud, and that's what I use a rasp for. I just slide this over the mud, and it just tears that mud right off. It takes a little hair off, but I don't use it for hair. I usually use it for mud. He's got a little mud right here. If I rub that around in a circle with a rasp, it just removes that mud. It breaks down the packed down mud right here. You see some packed down mud right here? By rubbing this rasp, you can hear it kind of grinding it into dust. And I just kind of rub this rasp around. Doesn't hurt him. I'm not grooming him. Sometimes instead of just getting a comb in there and pulling that dirt, this rasp takes most of the big knots out. And if it's really big, I'll just kind of go over them with it. And you can tell the rasp will remove. This is the rough side of the rasp. If I want to use the smooth side, it's even less abrasive. But it doesn't really chew up that mud like the rough side. So using the rough side, obviously I'm going to get a little bit of hair. Like I said, I don't use this for grooming because I don't think it does that great of a job. But if you got nothing else, I guess you can use it. And then this little thing here, really good for the undercoat. Let me remove this hair here. And it collects all the undercoat here and those little bitty fine things. And it just really does a nice job, especially on the cat. Cat's hair is a little bit more coarse. Dog's hair is a little more coarse. But when a horse has his long hair, like right here, anywhere you got a lot of long hair, this little brush right here does a great job. But for shorter hair, it doesn't work. So probably wouldn't want to use this in the summer when a horse is slicked out. And you don't want to use it in the winter either because it'll strip out his undercoat. But if you're trying to remove his undercoat and cool him off for the summer, this is a pretty good job. And again, I go against the grain when I'm trying to strip. There's an old saying, that guy's so stupid he got no horse sense. He'd rub a horse against the grain. And instead of petting them with the grain, they come, oh, that's a nice horse. And that irritates a horse. That kind of feels like a spider or something odd. You know, if you got any horse sense, you're going to pet a horse with the grain. Unless you're trying to spread the oils or clean them. But so this little thing here, you got to kind of keep pulling off because it fills up. But to really strip out that undercoat without using a whole bunch of effort. It's small. It's not real big for a horse. But I get this much hair off the cat when it's summer also.
And then this little blade is a hacksaw, and it more tears it, and there's some brush on the market that they said they just put like three or four hacksaw blades together in a wood thing. So when you rake it across, it's like three or four of these. And as you can tell, if I keep this thing straight, it does remove some hair. Again, I wouldn't try to groom a horse with a hacksaw, but if that's all I had and I wanted to get some hair off him, well, then I guess I could do it. Because it will, and again, as long as I don't go this way, I'm not going to saw into the horse. I'm just using the kind of little bites of the teeth there to kind of get some hair off him. And this seems, I almost seems like this cuts the hair. So this kind of thins it. Which, in the summer you might want to thin it. I don't want to thin it too much because then the sun will get to it. But my all-time favorite, I don't know what I did with my blade, is that blade that you usually see me use. And I really like that one. And then the curry comb, of course, to finish up and to come back in a circle and really spread those oils out. You're not going to take off a lot of hair. It's not going to ball up like that. But when you look in your curry comb, you should have the short hair getting in there. So a grooming process, when somebody tells me, goes out and they take a brush and they brush the horse and they go, I just groomed it. I'm like, are you kidding me? You want to remove that loose hair, get around, spread those oils, give your horsey a little horsey massage, go against the grain. This is one time that you want your horse to be desensitized. I don't want to do it so rough that it hurts him, but going in circles and against that grain really helps get that shine out. Make him cool easier. I'm spreading those oils so when it rains, the water's going to beat off. He's not going to get soaking wet, which means he's going to dry quicker, which means he's less likely to get rain rot. So there's all kind of good things about grooming your horse. My shoulder's still a little jacked up, so doing those feet today. So you see right here, he's got a big old dirt clod. It's kind of matted down with mud. So that's when I'll take the rough side of my rasp and just kind of rub that out a little bit. And now that dirt's gone and it's not sticking on his curry comb. And now I can get in there with that curry comb and really get in there and do him good. So anyway, those are the different little grooming things I want to kind of go over. Like I said, the blade or the rake, whatever they want to call it, I kind of like that the best. I like that when we did our dogs. Seemed to work pretty good. Hopefully I was in camera. Mr. T didn't move too much. And you can see and you can hear with the wind. Yeah, I guess I'm pretty much in camera. You couldn't see all that fur, but that's all right. Mr. T, you're a good old boy. Buddy's ear pretty much healed up out there. I'm going to do his feet next. And it's all muddy and the horse's feet are wet and they're chipped. Good thing about doing feet when it's wet is they trim easy. So you don't have to use a lot of strength. That makes it easier. Sometimes people will let their horse stand a little bit of water before they trim them and it softens up the hoof. Now it'll wet your rasp, and it can cause rust if you don't lay your rasp in the sun, let it dry out real quick. And it also will, if they step in the mud and your feet are wet, you're going to create more mud. So, but if you want to wet your horse's feet, if you have a horse that, like Mr. T's got really hard feet, man, in the summer when his feet are hard, man, it's tough cutting his feet. It's like every cut is like a strain. But today, because he's been soaking in water and they were a little overgrown and my shoulder's been hurt and I haven't done it, I called a farrier. I was going to have a farrier come out and do their feet because my shoulder was hurting. And the farrier was like, oh, I'm kind of busy. I was like, whatever, I'll do it myself. I told him I normally do it myself, but I was just hurt. So he's probably like, this isn't a long-term client. He probably wasn't willing to go over a whole bunch with me. So anyway, we'll end that there. Hopefully that helps on a little grooming tools. Mr. T, you're a good old boy. Buddy, you're next, boy. You're in big trouble. You're gonna get a beating. Crazy horse.